Hi everyone, I'm Shikazuki Kikuchi from Japan. I'd like to thank you for giving the chance to speak here today. I'm going to talk about acquired stuttering. As you know, there are two types of stuttering: right foot onset fluency disorder and acquired stuttering. Acquired stuttering includes drug-induced stuttering, psychological stuttering, and neurogenic stuttering. Neurogenic stuttering is divided into traumatic brain injury, TBI, cerebrovascular accident, and neurodegenerative disease. I have previously published a paper on neurodegenerative disease. There is an article published in 2018, Journal of Fluency Disorder. In this article, acquired stuttering relates BGTC dysfunction, dopaminergic treatments improved stuttering like this fluency. However, the patient died 2 years. Neurogenic stuttering do not become more fluency with rhythmic speech or speaking slowly. Paradoxically, the condition may be therapeutically useful for some patients. Each therapy is known to be effective psychogenic stuttering. Here, I report a case speech therapy was remarkably effective in treating an acquired stuttering that began after traumatic brain injury. The patient is a 34 years old male. He is married with two children and has no history of stuttering. One day, he had traffic accident with a truck. He had 10 centimeter wound on the right temporal region. CT imaging show subcutaneous hemorrhage in the right temporal region, but there were no abnormal intracranial findings. 3 days later, MRI showed no abnormalities in his brain. He was told it was a very serious car accident that could have killed him. Remembering the accident, he became frightened. 10 days later, he suddenly started stuttering, repeating words. 11 days later, MRI&EEG テストとか小腸のアブノーマリティー。He was diagnosed as suffering due to acute stress disorder. He was prescribed sleeping pill, but he did not seem to help. His suffering continued after 56 days. He first came to see my hospital. At the time of the initial visit, his stuttering frequency was 43%. Dyspraxia was characterized by fluent repetition and conquered the beginning of functional words. He also had trouble with heart palpitation and tremors. Emotions were running high. As for treatment, I first noticed that training with a metronome was effective for stuttering. Dealing around with him and me was not very effective. Next, treat palpitations and tremors, I decided to prescribe a beta blocker, which suppresses the sympathetic nervous system. Course of treatment. For the first 2 weeks, he practiced reading aloud to a metronome. Next, I instructed him how to speak without using a metronome, prolonging the first word. His success story was that he was able to use metronome and speak fluently during the first visit. Previously, when he read picture books to the child, he had difficulty reading aloud due to his stuttering. He was actively reading picture books to the child in an attempt to correct his stuttering. His wife saw the change in his involvement with his child, and she changed to be more cooperative. He practiced controlled speech with his wife. He does not tremble when his emotions run high. His stuttering fluency was 43% at the first visit, but gradually decreased to 0% after 2 months. He was able to return to work 3 months later. It was after a head brain injury, but the onset was 10 days later. It could be considered psychogenic stuttering. People with TBI and PTSD are more likely to develop acquired stuttering. I experienced one case in which the stuttering disappeared within 2 months using a metronome, prolonged speech. 最後ジェネティックスタートリングインプローブズ70%ウィズビヘイバーステラピー、ノーマルはニアノーマル。コンクルージョン。Speech therapy was suggested to be useful to use for acquired stuttering after her car accident. The time difference between New York and Japan is 13 hours. I am sleeping time, so I would be happy to have you contact me directly by email or other means for feedback or question. But thanks so much for taking time to join today. Bye.